I think that technology will cause us to really rethink the value of emotional and relational labor. And so one adjustment that we're going to have to make is to start teaching these things and thinking of them as skills that you can practice and get better at.
So I don't think that robots are going to steal all of the jobs, but what I do think they're going to do is they're going to make some people's jobs much better and other people's jobs kind of worse. And if there's one thing that I think we ought to do is think about, actually, instead of worrying about the jobs that are going, let's worry about the jobs that we know are staying. And some of those are definitely going to be jobs in things like social care, nursing, looking after people. Humans are the only ones that have the kind of compassion and kind of physical abilities to do this. So let's think about how to value them more so that actually they're good jobs instead of terrible jobs.
I think the challenge is going to be working in an environment where there aren't just people to manage, but there are people working alongside robots. We haven't necessarily got management and leadership right in the current world, so you chuck another piece into that equation, and are we going to be able to work it out? Are we going to get that right? So I think if we were to change something, it would be to change the way we lead and manage people now, so that it's resilient for the changing world of work when we've got AI, robots, technology contributing more to the world of work.
I think paradoxically, the growing role of technology in business is going to mean that at work, we have to think less about technology, more about people and how they think. And I think that's going to require very different skills than the STEM educational factory currently produces. I think we're going to need more artists, more imagination, and a great deal more social capital.
So I think the future of work will be profoundly impacted by technology, and I think we can already see many signs of that, not just in the nature of the jobs that we do, but the tasks that we perform, the skills we need, the types of work and types of jobs that we have, which are changing, and then even the nature of organizations. So there's a lot of opportunity there, but we have to think differently, and I think the big thing is about how do we understand these changes, not just in jobs, but in skills, in types of work that we perform, in our careers, and understand the policy and implications, the legal implications, the educational implications for all of that. And I think those are the big questions we need to be challenging ourselves with more and more.